Welcome, we'll start with the Psychology NET paper for November 2017. We'll start with paper 2 and move forward to paper 3. Today we'll be covering the first 25 questions for paper 2. Now the very first question talks about the concept and the description. Most of the questions were direct based on the definition. So if you are thorough with the concepts, the questions were easy. Now the first question, type is a cluster of many dispositions or traits. When we talk about trait, it's a kind of unique or consistent style of behavior that a person follows. So trait is matching with the first one. Then you have the system. System, we say, is a collection of the personality where you reflect the overall behavior of an individual, while the structure is the qualities that define an individual. So these are the correct matches for this question. Now next question is, which of the following is true for the tip of the tongue state? Tip of the tongue state means you feel that you know something, but it's not exactly coming onto your mouth. You are not able to retrieve it. So it's not a retrievable memory. So that's incorrect. There is a feeling that you know. There is a feeling that the memory is available. So 1 and 2 would be the correct answer. So A and B would be the correct choice for this question. Now next question talks about assertion and reason. Now conditioning done using partial reinforcement decreases the resistance to change or extinction. That's correct. So if you have, let's say, a fixed variable and let's say comparing the fixed and the variable. So you have the variable ratio and variable interval, and then the fixed ratio and the fixed interval. So for the fixed ratio and the fixed interval, the organism or whatever on which the experiment is well acquainted with the fact that there would be a kind of response only, or response would be provided after a fixed interval. So he is expecting that, but that's not the case for the variable ones, the variable ratio and the variable interval. So therefore partial reinforcement schedules re-influences the rate of responding. That's a correct explanation for this assertion. So both the statements are true and reason explains this statement correctly. Now next question is, you have to arrange the clinical scales of MMPI 2 in the correct sequence. Now the correct sequence is 2. So you have the various scales in the following order. So the first is hypochondriasis, then you have depression, hysteria, psychopathic deviate, masculinity, femininity, paranoia, then you have psychasthenia, schizophrenia, hypomania, and finally you have the social introversion. So that's the correct order for this scale. Now Alport defined personality as, so Alport, we are talking about F.H. Alport here, and he was basically a pioneer in social psychology. He explained personality as a result of social stimulus value. So social stimulus is the correct answer. And you have, in his words, we can say personality is defined as an individual's characteristic reaction to a social stimuli, and therefore social stimuli would be the correct answer. Now the next question, you are talking about the long-term potentiation. Now it's very important, the recent researchers have shown that there are two terms that we use, the long-term potentiation and long-term differentiation and depression. Under long-term depression you have low frequency, under long-term potentiation we talk about high frequency. So that's the first thing that you must check out. Then since it's long-term potentiation and it's the stimulation of presynaptic neurons with high frequency, this is a correct statement. And there is increase in the synaptic strength that is due to the stimulation of presynaptic and postsynaptic neurons. So both of these are correct statements and are independent. So you have 2 as the correct choice here. Now next question talks about, the concepts allow us to identify things without relearning. There are 2 things that we talk about under concept building. First is categorization and better organization, and the second is the concept of identifying without relearning. So you have 2 as the correct answer here. Now this is an interesting question where you have to answer the correct sequence in terms of increasing abstraction. So you have negation, then you have disjunction, that's the concept of OR, and the alternative denial, that is NAND. So you had the lowest abstraction that could be seen in negation, followed by disjunction and alternative denial. So A, C and B would be the correct option. So 2 would be the correct answer here. Now next question, you have to match the description with the concept. There are two things. So first is talking about the transformations. So under clustering, we talk about transformation of the order of items. Under coding, we talk about transformation of the content of the items. So this two are done. Now we move on to the learning. When we say we are using mediators, we are learning to learn. And this learning to learn is a sub part of non-specific transfer. So they, under transfer, we talk about specific transfer and non-specific transfer. Under non-specific transfer, you further have warming up and learning to learn. So under warming up, so under learning to learn, you are using the various mediators. But under non-specific transfer, you are basically learning how to perform a given task. So one would be the correct answer for this. So these are the correct matches. Now, the next question, binocular cue depends on. So what we basically have is a binocular cue, and there is use of both the eyes. So image is formed by both the eyes together. So combination of the images in the right and the left retina is correct. The way two eyes work together, that's again correct. And then the difference between the image and the two eyes, since the distance is 6 centimeters, what we say between the two eyes, and therefore there is a stereosmosis that is formed, and therefore you have A, B and D as the correct choice. Now for the other animals, you have monocular vision that we talk about. So here we are talking about binocular cues, and the correct answer would be A, B and D. We will talk about this in more detail when we will be discussing the topic on perception. Now the next question, for the 11th question, based on the diagram, the correct answer is 2. The next question, Broca's area is located in the frontal lobe. Again, a very direct question. Broca and Wernicke area are the commonly asked questions every time. So be particular with those. Assertion reason. Now here there is some problem with the reason statement. So make sure this is basically the Yerkes-Dodson law. So you have maximum arousal at a maximum performance at a medial arousal. So you have generally performance is optimum when the arousal is low. It's an incorrect statement, and again this statement itself is incorrect. So there should be some alternate statement with the reason. So that could be that the optimum level of arousal is higher for simpler tasks as compared to the complex tasks. So if that was the reason, this reason would have been correct. However, for now the language of either of these is incorrect. So this should be a bonus question. The next is, motivation is best understood as a state that energizes and directs the behavior. So 4 is the correct answer. Now next question, you have the various concepts and you have to match the correct thing. So the first is functional fixedness hypothesis. Now as the name suggests itself, you are fixed about something. So even that shows a kind of biasness. Even you are working on the wrong direction, you will continue to work on the wrong direction. So for this, the correct answer would be the thoughts in the wrong direction. The next is equivalence hypothesis. Now here we talk about whatever the modality, the input will be the same. So be it any modality that you are using, the input would remain the same. The next is manipulative hypothesis. Now this talks about the mental manipulations that are formed which are similar to the actual objects. And finally, the object imagery talks about the set that would make the images of all material almost similar, look almost similar. So you have these as the correct matches for this question. Now next is, if you want to have the detailed explanation, those are available at doorstep tutor. Now next is, you have to match the type of the memory and the explanation for the same. So you have the declarative memory that talks about the facts, the dates, the names. So it's a kind of very obvious memory and it's declarative memory. Then you have the procedural memory, where you are working with the procedure, how to drive, how to type, how to write. So that's a procedure that you are working around. Episodic talks about when the event happened, how the event happened, where it happened, when and where basically. So that's episodic. And when you talk about recoding, you are trying to combine various letters and phrases in the sentences. So that's recoding. Now next question is, now this is a direct definition for contingency management. Contingency management implies a purposive manipulation of the reinforcement contingencies that encourage certain behavior. So the correct answer is contingency management. The next question, the depth cue is based on two muscular feedbacks. One is accommodation, there is convergence. Since accommodation is the choice, you have accommodation as the correct answer. As we said, there were a lot of questions on perception. We would be discussing perception in detail in the upcoming lectures. The next is nomothetic approach in personality was emphasized by. Now, there were two ways of approaching the personality. One was nomothetic, that showed the personality traits are common to all. The other was ideographic. Now, Alport, however, gave the term nomothetic and ideographic. However, his philosophy was mainly ideographic because he gave more than 18,000 terms that could characterize an individual personality, and most of them, few of those were nomothetic and the remaining were very unique to an individual. So the correct answer here would be the Cattell's Big Five theory and the Ising's theory. So C and D would be the correct answer. So you have C and D as the correct option. The next is Spearman proposed the existence of a specific factor of intelligence, that's correct. Along with the G factor, he talked about the S factor. And by using the tetrad differences, he explained the theory of intelligence. And under the tetrad differences, he explained that the tetrad differences are always equal to 0. And that was one of the reasons for his theory of intelligence. So you have reason as the correct explanation for the assertion, and both of those are correct. The next question, a very direct question from theory of emotion. So theory of emotion that implies every emotion is associated with a physiological change is the James Lang theory, because here you have a dog that is barking, so you have either increase in the heart rate or sweating. So that's a physiological reaction that is seen to this event, and therefore James Lang theory would be the correct answer. Next question. Now this is again a very direct question. Some people perceive wolf as dog because external features in a category of concepts are associated with each other. So sometimes people confuse wolf with a dog, and it's because of the external features in the concept. So both the statements are true and reason explains the assertion. The next question is, frequency at which the operant response occurs before it is systematically reinforced is known as the operant level. So you have operant level as a correct answer here. The next question talks about the factors that help us to adopt to an inverted vision. So the correct answer is active movement. So if there is a kind of independent existence, you would have active movement that would be less, and if you have a kind of dependence, then there would be more dependence, and therefore you would have more workout that would be needed to solve that issue. And therefore, to adopt to an inverted vision, we say the correct method would be, the correct factor would be active movement. So correct answer is 2 here. The next is, now this definition of C relations and to educe correlates was given by Spearman. So Spearman is the correct answer, and he explained intelligence in this term. So with this, we cover the first 25 questions. We'll be covering the next set of 25 questions in the upcoming class. So stay tuned. Have a very good day ahead.